So, you're an iOS developer. You develop in Xcode, right? Well, I'm here to tell you that developing for iOS and macOS in Visual Studio Code is nothing short of amazing. This approach allows developers to harness the power of lightweight, highly customizable, and cross-platform coding environment, breaking free from platform-specific constraints. This paradigm shift makes an exciting evolution in the development landscape, making the journey from creating iOS and macOS apps both accessible and extraordinary. So let's learn how you can ditch Xcode and start building in VS Code today. If you enjoy free stuff that I put out on YouTube, imagine what you can get for a paid product of mine. Go ahead and check out the link in the description for a 75% off on SWIFTUI camp. It's the best gift that you can give yourself for Christmas. Now today we are going to talk about how you can develop iOS apps without Xcode, and we are going to do that in VS Code. And I have created a blog post also. The link is in the description again. If you want to follow along in a readable format, make sure to check that out also. Now, why would we want to do that? Well, in my previous video, I have added ChatGPT 4 for free into VS Code, and I also added Swift/SwiftUI code completion to VS Code, so we can build our iOS and macOS apps inside VS Code alone. Now, we needed to switch to Xcode in order to build our project, which is not fine. We want to have an all-encompassing experience. We want to develop in VS Code. And while we are doing that, we want to have hot reload on the Xcode simulator. So this is what we are going to build out today. This is what I'm going to teach you how to do in just a few minutes. So the plan is that we are going to work with VS Code and ChatGPT 4 if you have installed that. Again, the link for that video should be somewhere over here in the cards. And we are going to link that up with Xcode, from which we are going to run the Xcode simulator, and while we are going to set all of this up, it will be side by side hot reloading the changes that we make in VS Code. So again, a long story short, we are going to work in VS Code and see our changes automatically inside the Xcode simulator. So first, what we need to do is create a brand new Xcode project, and what I have done here is created this in the previous episode, ChatGPT 4 for free in Xcode and VS Code. That's fine. What I'm going to do is just close this for now, because I want to move this out of the desktop/download/documents folder. I'm going to move it right over here outside, so we are not going to have permission issues. This holiday season, treat yourself to the priceless gift of knowledge. As the year draws to a close, I'm excited to kickstart the new one with a special offer for the January cohort of SwiftUI Camp. Enjoy an extraordinary 70% discount available until December the 24th. Make the most of the opportunity to master SwiftUI in just 4 weeks and elevate your skills as you enter the new year. If you're appreciated the free resources I provide here, imagine the value awaiting in the SwiftUI Camp. Hurry, as there is only 5 available seats. Secure a spot today and click the link in the description. Once that's done, we are going to open this up again. There we go. We have our Xcode project running. Great. What we need to do is install INJECT for INJECTIONIII, and that's a free GitHub library. Let's just click over here. Here it is. And what we need to do is grab the URL from here and go back to Xcode and go to our project, then select our project, package dependencies, click on the plus right over here, paste that URL in. Let's wait for it to fetch it up to the next major version. That's fine. Let's add that package and
That package over there. Great. So we have inject right over here. Our next step is to add it in. There we go. We want to add in xlinker and interposable linker flag into the other linker flags. So let's go back to Xcode and select our target. You want to add all of this to all of your targets if there are. Let's go to build settings and search for other linker flags. There it is. Now you don't want to add to both of debug and release. You just want to add it to the debug only. So let's click on plus right over here. It returns. So now that we have that over there, let's go back to Safari and see what are the next steps. We want to download the latest version of injection. Let's just go ahead and click on the link there again, and then select injectionfree.app.zip, unzip it, and drag and drop it to your applications folder. This is really important. It has to be inside the applications folder because Xcode is also inside the applications folder. You want to run it. I already have it installed. And then you want to open up the project. Now, the project needs to be the root folder of your application. So there we go. Let's select the project directory. And now let's just go back to Xcode and set up our view. First of all, we want to import inject. Let's just go back to our Safari so I can just simply copy and paste out what we have here. So first of all, at exported import injection, let's just add that at underscore exported. Yes, exported import inject. Now, if you don't like this, then you can just import inject into all of the views that are going to use it. If you are using this, then it's going to import it to all of your files. Also, make sure that this goes through the review team from App Store Connect, because we have this underscore exported. It might not be available, or it might not be allowed. Go ahead and check that out. So now that we have imported inject, what we want to do is add the observed injection var inject to our content view. So right over here, let me just remove the canvas. We don't need that canvas anymore. So what we want to do is add observed injection var inject. Okay, that's fine. We don't need to do anything with that. We just need to have that as a property wrapper. And then enable injection. Let's just go over here. Enable injection. Okay, so now let's just select either our phone or iPhone 15, a simulator. I'm just going to go with the simulator because, you know, now you can see it. But this will work, of course, with your phone also, which is really nice. You just work on VS Code and you see the changes on your actual phone, not just the simulator. So let me just resize this a little bit over here so we can see it better, and let's wait for this to launch. There we go. Let's just change this to Xcode, and if we switch to our simulator, we are going to see that now we have Hello Xcode. Of course, you can just do this side by side. I don't have enough space right over here. But once you are going to switch to your Xcode simulator, it will be changed, whatever you change in Xcode. But today's tutorial is about VS Code. So let's open up VS Code. There we go. Let's open our project. There we go. Open it up. Yes, I trust this. And then we can just go into our project. Here we go. We have our content view over here. And it says Hello Xcode. Let me just slide this over a little bit. And let's have some more room. And now we will see Hello VS Code. And as you can see, it's automatically adding it. It's really, really nice. Let's just go over there. It has some lag on the first try, but let's just go back to Xcode, maybe. Now, as you can see, this is automatically adding it. That's because I'm automatically saving this file. You need to set this up, so let me just show you how you can do this. Otherwise, just make your changes, hit Command S, and then it will be seen on the simulator. But we know we want to have autosave, so let's just go select code and then settings and settings again and search for autosave. There we go. And make sure that you select after delay right over here, and for the autosave delay, instead of 1000 milliseconds, just choose 1 millisecond. And that's it. Now you can just go ahead and have hot reload from your VS Code to the Xcode simulator. Let's just do that again. VS Code. There we go. It's really nice. Now, if you did enjoy this video, make sure to also check out SWIFTUI Camp, the January cohort. I have a 70% off discount. The link is in the description. And if you did like this video of how we are hot reloading from VS Code to the Xcode simulator, make sure to check out the previous video where I show you how you can add ChatGPT 4 for free into VS Code.